Most people in America are familiar with what is and isn't their personal opportunities. What I'm, of course, referring to is the opportunity to be correct under the law. To be correct under the law, you have to know what is and isn't your rights. You see, your rights belong to you with regard to your personhood, your actual physical body, your paperwork, meaning your legal records belonging to you in every way, and your possessions or your property, the presents you've received over your lifetime. You and you alone have the right to decide what you will and will not keep. At no time, once you reach the age of majority, does anyone ever have the right to make a peep about what you own, what you do, how you dress, how you do things with regard to any of those three things. Those three criteria, those three subject areas, are literally what every human being, once they reach adulthood, has the right to be in control of. There is no law enforcement officer, there is no medical director, there is no mental health shitbag, there is no social worker that has the right to take away your human rights underneath any federation or any United Nations treaty. The Declaration of Human Rights establishes that we have the rights to be free. And freedom means we are free of tyranny, and freedom means we are free of slavery, and freedom means we are free of human trafficking and information trafficking today. What we know is that human rights involve many things, and we move ourselves as communities, as Christian organizations, all throughout the world to produce a freedom that rings. Our Army and our Navy, our Air Force and Marines, they protect American citizens all over the world. They also protect our borders, we presume, because for the most part, in theory, we are safe from the rest of the world. We are, however, regularly impacted by foreign exchange students and international visitors for business international exchange. America Inc. is something that functions within the world today. In other words, we have gross domestic product that is sold all over the world today. We have manufactured capabilities that allow us the privilege of being America today. Our history and our heritage over the course of time since the beginning pilgrimage brought those things into being. And we thankfully moved away from slavery today. The problem is we still have people who are quite ethnocentric. I don't profess to be anything like that, but I do create an audio cast to challenge you in your thoughts on that. I do have the right to be vehemently angry with people of a particular color, nation, or creed, or race, or tribe that is abusing me today. I do have the right to be upset with people who have lied to themselves about their rights to me, my property, my pockets, my privileges, and everything that American citizenship offers me and you as well today. My biggest question when I hear about abuse or when I experience abuse is, who is next, please? Who is the next person to be targeted by a police officer's group and their family and friends to be abused today? Who is next to be targeted by a racist group, an ethnocentric group, a black supremacist group, to be harmed today? Recently, in the news, in the last year and a half, a brother, not at all, but a white man, was beaten to death by four blacks in a park, probably because the white man mouthed off a little bit too much, but that was totally Todd's personality. He did that with everyone indiscriminately, even people who put up with his Agent Orange problems that he received from the military long ago, allegedly, was how the story went or would go. In life, we have moments of time to understand that American citizenship offers us the freedom to right to life. And right to life as a movement has been used to abuse women's rights. We just saw that Texas totally, utterly abused God's rights in the world. You see, God is the privileged one who allows people to get pregnant when they do not practice safe sex. And openly, sometimes those children need that experience to grow themselves up and mature them into successful adults. Many, however, still stay stuck in the high school and junior high mentality of a child that went wild and did not protect their body from premature sex. Adults prefer to get married, have responsible relationships underneath any aspect of the law of intimacy. Meaning there are people like me and like you who might have had a relationship in college that was privileged, meaning it was independent, autonomous, and a loyalty-based situation where people lived together but they were not married to each other for whatever reason across the nation. In life, we have moments of time to speak the truth, and the truth is at no time do you have the right to interfere with anyone else's intimate relationships or opportunities for intimacy, or in that matter, sexual organs. We have liars across the world who think that they should debase, dehumanize, deface, and debilitize people who do not perform in their mindset how a person who is human should be. What we're, talking about is human sexuality, which is a private matter underneath every guise of any type of religion in the world. And yet there are arrogant people from different religious groups and different social networks that think they have the right to opinion about someone's life and organs. They also feel they have the privilege of insulting human beings about their rights to their own beings. This is a lie that men in Texas have told themselves. This is a lie of legislators, this is a lie of politicians, and this is a lie of anyone supporting that aspect of assault on someone's rights. You see, it's the individual who has the right to human life, meaning a person who is already living has the precedent over one that is not yet presently with us. Many people do not even know they're pregnant by the time they're pregnant at 6 weeks. That is something that was professed in a fairly well-written article by one of the best newspapers in the country. So what we have is people totally abusing people's rights to even handle themselves in a proper way, to make the educated decision about whether they should get married, whether or not they should let the baby go, whether or not the baby has Down syndrome, whether or not the baby will be healthy, all the things that one does with prenatal care. At the same time, we have children across America that are never taught appropriately not to mess around too early without carefully considering their responsibilities. Otherwise, we would not have teenage pregnancy and the idiots of America trying to impregnate people that never are meant to be that way. We have liars in a military force. We have liars in a law enforcement force. We have liars in a Christian right who think the best way to teach someone about their body is to rape them and ruin them with impregnation. How dare you think you have the right to enslave another human being to your sexual temptations? In life, we have moments of time to speak the truth of God, and it's the Lord above who puts the soul within a being. And if that being has birth defects, we don't always know about them. If that being has birthmarks, we don't always see them. Most people in America have a birthmark somewhere on their body. It's hard to say the purpose of that mark. Maybe that's the mark of the Lord in a different and unique way. But what I'm saying to you today is you better focus on your life in every way. If you are an individual single person, then focus on what you can do to make your life the best in every way. Find out how to achieve the lifestyle you want by the time you reach retirement. Take your plan, work it backwards, and plan in a way that gets you where you want to go. In front of the people you need to meet, in front of the social networks you need to greet, and by God's grace, you'll get there as long as you never participate in the harm of anyone else in any type of offbeat behavior. In life, we have moments of time to speak the truth, and the truth is parents don't usually guide their children into appropriate opportunities for them because they don't always want to do it or they don't know how to do it. Very few parents spend every year reading one book on parenting. They just say, well, they'll either turn out or they won't. And the answer is no, that's not true. What that means is we end up with a society that won't protect either me or you. They won't protect our responsibilities, they won't protect our requirements, and they most definitely won't protect our rights. in life we have moments of time to speak the truth, and the freedoms that we currently have are because of many people who sacrificed in many ways across many cultures, many ethnicities, many nations, many tribes for us to become who we are today. In life, we have moments of time to see beauty in the world and what it brings to the world. And in life, we have moments of time to practice peace in every way.